ridiculous.
All right, now we're here. Now we're here with Bandigame Marco, and he has his mic. How are you today?
Oh, my. I'm good.
That's good. So you said something about looking like a kid. You don't look like a kid today. How old are you? Yeah. Tell the people.
I don't want to say it.
They can just Google it.
You got to keep some stuff in the records.
See, look, see, when you Google it, you're going to get the wrong information. Everything you find
out. He got people everywhere.
Everything you find on the internet is not real, I'm telling you. So you Google it if you want to.
Try it.
Google it. He's going to say 36.
Go on Instagram and let us know how old you think he is.
36 and a half.
I've been lying about my age since Bebo.
Since birth. He bopped out like, nigga, I'm two.
No, I said Bebo.
What's
that? Y'all know what Bebo is?
No, I'm tripping.
You know what Bebo is?
Nah.
Y'all know Bebo?
Put his own. Point his own.
One of the first websites. Yeah, before MySpace.
Oh,
Bebo.
See, I didn't even have a MySpace.
Bebo, yeah.
I skipped all of that.
What?
I ain't having MySpace.
I
think
Bebo
I came toward the end of MySpace when it wasn't cool no more, so I just didn't use it.
Crush Spot, Bebo, MySpace, all them. Yeah. They used to be popping though. Yeah.
So where are you
Tag.
From?
Oh, yeah, Simpson. That too. That was
the first one, though.
Tag was, like, after MySpace, right?
No, Tag was the first one.
It was
one.
First, yeah.
Oh, I found out.
Tag, Bebo, MySpace, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram.
I missed that whole trend.
Oh. Oh, I thought that man said Backpage.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Ridiculous.
Not on the juice box.
Uh-oh.
No.
That's crazy.
Tell the people where you from, though.
I'm from Simpson Road. I'm from the West Side.
Okay.
West Side in the building.
So you all about that Atlanta music. You hone it. You like.
Yeah.
You made it, credit. You consider yourself one of the creators, one of the innovators for Atlanta music?
I wouldn't say a creator, but.
Innovators. Kept it going.
Once I first came in, I was a little trend.
Right? Okay.
I was a little R&B trend, though. Like.
Tell us one of your first hits.
She got ready.
That really was a banger.
Seem like you're ready. I remixed R. Kelly. Oh, little kids.
I never
going
heard
crazy.
That.
It was probably crazy.
I'm not from Atlanta. I never heard it.
Where you from?
Detroit.
Probably why.
Yeah, that's definitely why.
So, how long you been doing it?
Since 2010.
Okay, so that's not too long ago.
Yeah.
So what made you start in 2010?
I wasn't really doing that now. I was too bad. They wouldn't let me play sports. So
ridiculous.
Yeah, so I just started playing around with it.
Yeah. I got a question, a real question.
Yeah.
What made you put those earrings on? Because they definitely hearts.
Oh, they are hearts. Look at that, adorable.
I had the earring for like 3 years. Like, I don't know. Like one of you know the block earrings they had when I was style.
Yeah,
right.
So I was like, let me take these blocks out my ear. The big block.
I like the cute little block earrings. I don't have a problem with those, but the big ones, what it looked like they hanging. No,
that was Atlanta though.
Everybody wanted big, flashy. Mm-mm.
So, who were you exactly before 2010? What did you do before 2010? You were just
bad.
Finding yourself.
A little bad West Side boy.
Yeah, I was just.
That's so interesting.
I was just doing bad. I wasn't really.
So how'd you start?
Start doing music.
Who first influenced? One of your major influences.
I didn't have an influence when I started.
Yeah.
It was just my friends who was doing it at first.
Uh huh.
Yeah. So we just.
So where you get your inspiration now? Any artists that inspire you now?
Not really. I used to be inspired by Jagged Edge, but that wasn't the reason I started. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
But I still like that music.
So what's your top five playlist? Like the top five songs you will?
All the old school songs, like Jagged Edge.
Oh, yeah. I like them.
Yeah, all the like the 90s, though. Like the 90s.
Yeah, music. 90s was popping, though.
Yeah, they had some good music.
They did.
Where I used to work, non-disclosed, you know, they used to play that all the time. All they used to listen to was Jagged Edge and fucking Britney Spears, all the old
Drew
stuff.
Drew Hill and Jay.
Drew Man. Hill.
I want to condition.
Player.
Yeah. So what's one of the heights in your career so far?
One of the what?
Heights.
I performed at Birthday Bash. That was like.
That was crazy. There was a lot of people with
it. Yeah, I was
crazy.
Scared.
You were scared.
Yeah. I walked out on stage.
Up there shaking
before I walked on stage, I was like, oh, man. Because I was backstage the whole time. So when I walk on the stage, ain't no people going to be behind me. So when I walk on stage, I'm like, oh, shit. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, dang. That's but when I walked out, everybody was screaming. So, like, I really wasn't scared no more.
That's the biggest crowd you performed for?
Yeah. They're like, what?
That was 30, a lot of people.
30,000 people.
It was a lot of people there. Yeah. Traffic was off the hook.
What year was that? Because I
that was last year. I performed 2000.
I think I was there last year. I feel like I was there.
No, you wasn't there.
I wasn't. No. What's that? It's one big A3C. I was at A3C last year.
Oh, they have
year.
Another one.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I was going to say. So, what's up? Any upcoming projects you got coming next?
I'm working on a mixtape, but I ain't really think of a name or none. Like, I just been doing music. Well, I've been doing music since my last mixtape. I probably got 100 songs.
Who been really producing the...
Everybody. I've been telling producers just since then. Yeah. Different. You know what I'm saying?
That's what's up, though.
Yeah, I don't be picky about who
makes it. Give everybody a chance to be heard.
Yeah.
So, what's some of the roadblocks that's coming, that you come in with during your career? Any... people who trying to stop your shine.
Yeah. I can't say that name, though.
Right. You don't got no crazy stories for us? One time, man.
I don't want to say it.
Oh, it's cool.
It's a big road. It's two big roadblocks.
Mm-hmm. But you overcome. You find ways to overcome, right?
Overcoming.
Okay. Cool.
Still overcoming.
Yeah.
It's hard out here, you know?
Yeah.
We need to get...
Watch out for the snakes.
They everywhere.
Yeah, well, real.
But on a more positive note, we can get to know the real Marco and ask you some juicy questions. You cool with that?
Go ahead.
See, now, these are all going to be surprising to you because you ain't, you know, checked the email, sir, to look through the questions. So, you ready? Number one celebrity crush you got right now.
I don't have one.
Man, you are no fun.
That's why I don't never make a woman crush Wednesday because I don't really crush on nobody.
Wait, you got a girlfriend though, right?
Until today.
You crush it. Oh, you were? He was crushing. He was crushing.
Something happened earlier.
Ridiculous.
A couple hours ago, man.
It's cool though.
It's crazy
cool.
How things turn around real quick.
It's gonna turn right back around.
That was my crush. I used to pull her though. I ain't had no celebrity crush. I don't really crush on people. Too old for that.
Okay, so Bandigging Marco, the lover. Where would you take a girl on the first date?
If you could go
anywhere.
I don't know. So, I gotta chill with a person before a date. Because I might not even like you once I chill with you. So, I don't want to be stuck on a date with you. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Yeah, so. But on the first date, I just let the girl chew. After right. we chill.
Guys always be like, where you want to go?
Yeah.
Where you want to go? They be like, I don't care. Where you want to go? Where you want to go? It's always back and forth. Always. Right.
Yeah.
So, conversation starters, how you talk to a girl? Hey, yo, shorty, I'm Bandigging Marco.
So, you're saying, like, when I'm trying to talk to a girl? Like,
yeah. Pick up lines. Come on, what's up? Let me get at you.
So, you don't...
Them jeans.
So, he don't want to answer because you don't use no pickup line. Really yeah, they come up really. To you, right, and use their pickup line, right? Right? Okay. All right. I see.
A little
I don't know. I really ain't been... I don't know. I ain't good at talking to girls, to tell you. I don't ever try. I don't really never try.
So
I
how?
I ain't really good at it.
So in high school, how are you? Like nerdy, cool guy, jock?
I was bad as hell, man. But I
it's
was
all
quiet.
A blur.
I was quiet, but I was bad. Like everybody knew me. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't say I was popular, but I don't know. It was a different kind of popular.
I
guess everybody knew me because I was bad. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
It was different.
I feel like I know what kind of child you was growing up in Baltimore because we had a lot of those.
Yeah.
Bad. My brother was one. He's still bad to the bone right now.
Yeah.
Where he at? So let's talk about this hairstyle of yours because it's very different. What inspired you?
No,
to do that?
It's not really that different. He looked like you off Kid and Play. He looked like he off Kid and Play.
Right.
You know
okay.
How And they still got their hairstyle like that, too. It's too funny.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. I just wanted to try something different. You know, I had a little temp since high school. You know what I'm saying? I had that haircut before everybody. I swear to God. I had that haircut before everybody. Any rapper, I had that haircut before all of them.
So, basically, I feel like everybody in Atlanta is trying to grow their hair out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I feel like everybody's trying to get dreads. But I just hate that
they're trying to, they're trying to twist it and they got these little worms on their head. For real, it's just crazy.
I did that before. I was trying to make my hair grow, but I wasn't trying to get dreads or nothing. But
yeah. I don't like it. Ugh. I don't like it.
So let's get back on the music side of you. If you could work with any artist, which artist would you work with? Drake. Dead or alive?
Drake.
Drake? Why you
dead
say
dead or alive? I mean, I fuck with him.
I like
Drake. He a single rapper. Right. Like I'm a single rapper.
So y'all are compatible in the music.
Yeah.
All right.
And
that's
I feel like I'm talented like a motherfucker. I feel like, not trying to be cocky or nothing, but I feel like I'm talented like hell.
That's good, though. Yeah. You got to believe in you or nobody else will.
So what you think about this little feud that's going on with Drake and Meek Mill? How you feel about that?
I feel like Meek Mill isn't taking life serious, though.
He overstepped his boundaries.
Like he just playing, like, I feel like he just sleep on it. Like, that shit, nigga, that shit can be dangerous. You know what I'm saying? That shit probably can end your career for real.
Yeah, they had a concert Sunday up here. Yeah. And I just really want to know how it turned out.
Somebody said that Drake was performing, and behind his performance, he had, like, all the memes and all the shit that about Meek on Instagram, how they been saying all that shit. They had the memes in his performance. That's so mean.
I'd say he's taking it too far, though. Drake taking it too far.
He took it way, way.
Right.
Way.
He just trying to show that he, I guess, bigger. He the big dog, but.
He taking it too far. He just. Meek had no reason to tweet if he wasn't gonna reply like that, but but I mean.
So what's one of your worst pet peeves? Something you cannot stand.
Something I can't stand.
Yeah, worst pet peeves get on your nerves, annoy you.
I get irritated by everything.
That's ridiculous. It's crazy.
I hate being in traffic. I think.
Yeah, that's annoying.
Yeah, I hate being
I'm a crazy
too.
Driver, yeah.
Because I'd be on the speed.
And then I got like a monster truck, so I'd be on the sidewalks. You know, like, that's
vandalism.
I got a big old truck, so I just get on the sidewalk and just. Like, yesterday, 285 was not moving. I backed all the way out the spillway. I was on like the middle, I was like in the middle of the traffic, and I backed. I went
Who
to the
does
side.
That? That's crazy.
Yeah, I hate being in traffic.
I would have been sitting there for an hour. I would not have done that. I would have been the one that got caught.
So, have you had any weird experiences with fans, like crazy fans that would just run up to you like, Bandit?
Yeah, I used to stay on the south side at Ford Park. And I was driving in my neighborhood, and there was a whole bunch of kids like walking in the neighborhood. And they turned around and seen me through the windshield. So, I had sped off and drove to the house. And they found my car. And they just knocked on every door in the neighborhood.
Dang.
And they was like opening the doors and I was like, oh man, I was looking at my window.
What you think they was gonna do? You was hiding from the little kids?
No, I was laughing, but I was like,
kids bad though, not
them folks went to every house on the neighborhood.
That's crazy.
That must feel real good. Like they was looking for you.
Yeah. It felt good. I recorded it. I don't know where that video went.
I'd have been scared for my life. Like, they going to tell somebody else. They going to knock my door down, come get me in my sleep.
Yeah, I had to move after that. I was like, I got to move over here.
That's crazy. Yeah. So, you had any weird, embarrassing moments while performing or anything? Crazy stories, like Beyonce got her hair cut in that fan that time?
My only embarrassing moment probably when I hit a note wrong or something.
Mm-hmm.
And the music had stopped or something like that. It was like... I was like, damn, just kept going, though.
Right, nobody noticed if you keep going, for real.
Nah, they noticed. When the music dropped.
Yeah. Right, okay.
Yeah.
Like, but shit happens, they know.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, it definitely happens. There's some crazy stuff that didn't happen on the stage.
So, with your music, you think about moving forward, going on any tours, anything?
Yeah. We supposed to be setting up a tour now.
Can release any details or not yet?
I don't really have too many details, so I really don't even want to talk about it. But yeah, but we supposed to be we supposed
keep
to be
look
setting,
out.
You know what I'm saying? We supposed to be setting up a tour.
That's dope.
Yeah.
Can you give the people your social media so they can follow you and all that?
Yeah, follow me on Instagram at Bandit Gang Marco. Marco with a V instead of an A. Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, Marco Real Life. Subscribe to my YouTube at Bandit Gang Marco.
Right. It's a lot of, when you search on Instagram, make sure you get that right. Because I saw like six pages of Bandit Gang Marco while I was trying to.
Yeah, that's why I changed my name, because it's a catfish page. He going like to the stream.
They got like catfish. Six of them. Man.
He no, popping. I'm talking about this page. He got like 27K and he following like 100 people, so it looked real. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And he just taunting every girl. He just comment on it. I seen it. Taunting some girl. Like, he'll leave a comment on their page and just say number. And they'll send the number. I'm like, oh, man. And the name looked just like mine, but he got a.
That's spooky.
He got like one I in Bandit. He got an extra I in Bandit.
Oh, yeah. I think
so it's
I
like BANDIIT and then Gang Marco.
That's cute. If somebody want to get me a little catfish, go ahead.
You ain't popping if you ain't got no catfishes, for real.
I'm telling you, ain't going to like it. I promise you.
So, oh, we need to give one more shout out to our designer, though. Violet Rose, 78 INC.
Ladybugs.
Right. And thank you for coming on the show. Thank you for chilling with us. Yeah. You kept it real juicy. Mm-hmm. So we're going to set you free. We're going to be right back.